Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. In the numerical series program today, I will begin with some numerical from kinematics today. Today, two numericals, one on the concept of velocity time graph and another numerical on acceleration time graph. Very important numerical. So in this first numerical, displacement and distance, we have to find displacement and distance in this graph. 20 meter per second, here is the velocity at this point, and after 4 seconds this point B, after 4 seconds this point A. Means the graph starts from O to A, A to B, B to C, D to E. In this graph, how can we calculate displacement and distance? So in VT graph, we already know that displacement is the area of the graph. Displacement, this is in the first quadrant. Displacement in this here will be area of this, and displacement here is the area of this BCDE portion. So for displacement, total displacement, this area minus this area will give you displacement, total displacement. And in VT graph, for distance, the area of this triangle plus area of this rectangle. Means in distance part, we have to add the area, lower area and upper area. For displacement, this area minus this area. And for distance, this area plus this area in VT graph. So let us solve it. The area In VT graph, area represents displacement. So the net displacement, is equal to area of OAB, area of triangle OAB plus area of rectangle BCDE. In for displacement, this sign will be minus, because this is in the negative side of this axis. So this is the minus one. Area OAB, this is a triangle. So this triangle area half into base means OB into height, this one AM. Suppose this is AM, this point is M, AM. Minus area of this rectangle, L into B, this is BE into BC. So half into OB means 4 second, AM means this is 20, this height represent by velocity, that is 20, minus BE 4 into BC, that is 20. So calculate 40 minus 80, that is minus 40. This is meter. Displacement is a vector quantity, so negative sign is valid here. Now for distance, in this question, total distance, that is this plus this, area OAB, like that, triangle OAB plus area of this rectangle BCDE. So here OAB, this area, the value of this comes to be how much? This area, this directly comes to be 2 into 2, this 40, and here plus the same value, here the same value, that is 20 into 2, 40, and this plus 80, that is equal to 120 meter. So this is the distance. Now let us come to the second question, that is acceleration time graph. For acceleration time graph, first of all, it is very important to understand the concept. What any graph represents? Acceleration time graph is a very important graph. In this graph, time on x-axis, acceleration on y-axis. In this graph, suppose any area is given. So the area in AT graph always represents change in velocity. OAB. You can take this example from here to here, like that. First of all, I am giving you the concept that how, what it represents. So velocity, area is equal to area of OAB is equal to change in velocity from here to here and here to here. So what is that net change in velocity? That is given by this concept, change in velocity. So area of AT graph, suppose this is 2 second time, and suppose this acceleration is 20. Therefore, area of this graph, of this triangle, will be equal to half into base OB into height, this height. Let this height be AM. So 1 by 2 into OB, that is 2, into AM, that is 20. 2 to cut, this is 20 meter 20, and since it is represent change in velocity, so its unit will be meter per second. Because area of AT graph change, the change of the velocity. Now in this concept, another concept also, that what would be the average acceleration? So average acceleration from here to here will be total area by total time. So average acceleration is equal to area by time. And what is the area? 20. And what is the time taken from here to here? 2 seconds. That is 10 meter per second. This is the average acceleration. So in average acceleration and change in velocity, these two important concepts can be calculated from the acceleration time graph. Both the numericals, if you find any problem in the concept of these numericals, you can ask the phone number given in my YouTube channel. So I think in the next class I will give you some basic concept regarding the next topic, and that topic will be vector quantity. Very important class, so please don't miss that class. To find the video of that class, it is important that you should like, subscribe and share, so that the video could be reached to you. Thank you.